Welcome to Crayola Creativity Week. Today's theme is leaping toward dreams. Our special guests are Misty Copeland and Christopher Myers. Misty, please introduce yourself and tell us how you became a dancer and how your early experiences influenced your creative expression today.
Hi, I'm Misty Copeland, ballerina, public speaker, film producer, and author of Firebird. My first formal dance experience was when I was in middle school. Some people said that the age of 13 was too late to start working towards a career in ballet, but I have never listened when people told me what I couldn't do. I attended ballet classes at the local Boys and Girls Club and then moved to the San Pedro Ballet School so that I could learn from my teacher, Cynthia Bradley. As a teenager, I won first prize in ballet at the Los Angeles Music Center Spotlight Awards, and then a full scholarship to the summer intensive at the San Francisco Ballet. I worked so hard in every program, which is how I've continued to grow and succeed. I noticed that there weren't a lot of dancers who looked like me participating in this art form. I want all kids, regardless of where they live or what they look like, to know that all the arts are available to them and that creativity lets them leap towards their dreams.
Christopher, please introduce yourself and tell us how you became an artist.
Hey, my name is Christopher Myers. I'm a person who makes things. I make art, I make books, I make theater. My father was a person who made things. He was a well-known children's book author who wrote more than 100 books and served as the national ambassador for young people's literature. Those early collaborations with my father, when I illustrated his books and co-wrote them with him, they helped me to understand that creativity could be put anywhere. That's why today I make so many different kinds of things. I love to work with other artists, like Misty Copeland. I've always been concerned, like she is, with the amount of representation that there is for African Americans, for people of color in general, for all of the communities that don't find themselves in all of the worlds in which I'm making things. And to that point, I publish other people's books, stories that are kind of desperate to see the rest of the world. We understand where we live and we understand where other people live because of the creativity of artists like myself, like Misty, like all of you.
Misty, please read the book Firebird and explain how it represents your personal story.
The space between you and me is longer than forever. You are the sky and clouds and air. Your feet are swift as sunlight, stretching across the skyline like the day-long sun over the horizon. Me? I'm gray as rain, heavy as nap time, low as a storm pressing on rooftops. I could never hope to leap the space between. Darling child, don't you know you're just where I started? Let the sun shine on your face. Your beginning's just begun. Before the curtain rises, before the spotlight falls, before the fireworks of costumes, before it all. I was a dancer just like you, a dreaming shooting star of a girl with work and worlds ahead. There I am, sweating at the bar. I had 1,000 leaps and falls, switching worn-out slippers swift as applause. Even birds must learn to fly like me. You'll grow steady in grace, spread an arabesque of wings, and climb. Each position, 1 through 5, stair steps to the sky. That's right. You will soar, become a swan, a beauty, a firebird for sure. Soon, with the same practice, you'll join me in this dancing dream. in a pas de deux, a music box for two. We will wrap our hearts careful as ribbons on point shoes. We'll make the night sky our starry curtain, the moon our silver spotlight, as we spin across the planet, pirouetting tightly as the curls on our heads. Spinning wishes for new little ones we can't yet imagine. Then they will look to you in wonder, lighter than air and swift as sunlight, turning over the day and say, "The space between you and me is longer than forever, and I will show them that forever is not so far away." The end.
Wow, what a great story. In Firebird, you talk about having a mentor who encourages you to persevere. Please tell us about what inspired you and those who supported you.
When I was just 7 years old, I saw the film Nadia on TV, and the gymnast in the story became my role model. Though I had never studied gymnastics or dance, I decided to create self-styled choreographic routines with movements to fit all of my favorite music. Like my older sister, I became the captain of my middle school drill team. There, I caught the attention of the coach who encouraged me to take a ballet class. In the book, you meet my mentor, Raven Wilkinson, kneeling before me with her hands on my shoulders. She says, "Let the sun shine on your face. Your beginning has just begun." It was important for me to hear an accomplished dancer reflect on how she got started. She told me that she too started as a beginning dancer, just like me, a dreaming shooting star of a girl with work and worlds ahead. She told me that even birds must learn to fly. That's when I realized hard work and the support of others would enable me to fly like a bird, a bright, inspiring Firebird. As a principal ballerina, in our production of the Firebird, I performed the Sison attitude, which to me looks like an explosion of flames that made me feel like I was flying.
Chris, please explain why your art is often described as a visual narrative.
I like to tell stories. I like to tell stories in as many ways as possible. I think that when you tell stories in so many ways and you bring them together, that's what brings our story world to life. We want to exceed both our histories and our geographies. We want to touch the entire world. And in order to do that, you use as many tools as you can. My art focuses on transformation, how people change, how we learn that we are more than just the island of ourselves. I go between words and images and fabric and all of the tools that are at my disposal because I'm trying to talk to the whole world. So you can't talk just one language if you're going to speak to the whole world.
Chris, Firebird's illustrations are filled with collages. Please show us how you brought the Firebird scene to life through this art technique.
When I was growing up, I didn't always have all the materials I wanted. I didn't always have, you know, the fanciest paints or the fanciest pens and this kind of thing. But I always had, you know, lots and lots of paper around. There was lots of magazines and newspapers. I love collage because it's often about this sort of remixing of taking all of the various pieces, putting them together, and making a new world that you didn't have before. When I think about this book, Firebird, when I think about what Misty does as a dancer, and you know, dancers do this all the time. They find movements various places and then they incorporate them onto the stage. I think a lot about this idea of remixing, of you know, how all artists in the end are making collage, because you're taking all of the ideas that surround you, all of the kind of concepts, all of the you know, things that you see in your everyday life, and you're putting them together to make something new. And that's really the gift of collage for me, is this idea of constantly making something new from the materials that are around me and how many kinds of art forms there are that are in the end some kind of collage. For me, this starts with, first and foremost, getting a bunch of source material. And so when you think about what the source material is for a book like this, it's not only the magazines and the pieces of things that I'm cutting apart, but it's also, you know, Misty's dance itself. I went to the ballet a bunch of times just to watch her dance. And even the costumes that were designed for her to dance with, or the music, all of those things influence the work. And I love that part of being an artist, because it allows you to bring all yourselves to bear, all of the different ways you can think about something come together. When you make collage, it's like an understanding that everything in your life is part of the material that you are given to make something beautiful. So how this works is, first I make my materials. So I'm coloring onto this kind of paper, trying to build some texture, trying to build something that's maybe a little less flat. And then I'm drawing, but I'm drawing with a scissor. So right now I'm gonna draw another arm for this figure. And that idea of what I am doing is drawing, even when I'm cutting, is something that I love. In the end, it's always about both drawing and being really aware of what's around me, being really aware of what are the materials that make up the language of a place that I'm in. So, you know, these materials are one set of materials, and they really influence the way we see things when we have this kind of diversity of materials in front of us. Never feel limited by your materials. Feel like the limits sort of help you define what it is you want to say. One of the things about collage is that it allows you to borrow from all the rich things that are around you already, right? So that you don't have to build that richness from scratch. And so what I found is that with collage, you can build as rich a color as you can find in the world. And I love that. No matter where you are, especially if you're a kid, you're surrounded by something, and that should be the center of what you make. Everything around you becomes that center, becomes the center of what you can express, because it's around you.
Chris, please show us how you created one of the opening scenes that shows direction and movement.
One of the things that's sort of essential for this book, and one of the reasons why I was really excited to think about this book, is it's about an artist. It's about a young person who's an artist looking at an older person who's an artist, and that thing that we all felt when we were young and we were artists, that somehow that space between where you want to go and where you are is infinite. It feels like it will never, ever be surmounted, you know? And it takes work, and it takes time, and it takes thought, but eventually you get there, and that you can become that artist that you want it to be. We are all artists, we're at different stages, and that we will eventually find a way to be the artist that we want to be. And that's was, for me, the key into the book. You know, we all start somewhere, we all go somewhere, we all are artists that are like trying to get better. But know that everybody who you see drawing amazingly, at one point they were a little kid too. And they were trying to do this kind of work. They were trying to discover themselves as artists. Even if like you don't end up being an artist as your job, which I'm so lucky to say that, you know, that's my main job. It's still this beautiful thing that you're able to make something happen like that. That you're able to, you know, discover yourself anew, discover the world around you, and to discover what you can be. So when I'm drawing, I'm often like trying to physicalize what I see. And you know, one of the things that a drawing is really static, but it doesn't move. But you can make it move. You can kind of make it flow. And one of the ways to do that is to use a really flowy line. I love a brush pen because it has all the kind of weight to it. So you can go really thick and juicy, or you can go really thin. And I love that kind of sense of diversity of mark that you get with a brush pen. When you see Misty's costume, it's all kinds of weights of fabric, really heavy fabrics and really light ones. All of it creates this sense of movement, of flow. So I love a brush pen in that sense of really, really, really getting to the center of the idea that even what I'm doing here on the page is dance, is a way of thinking about movement, is a way of thinking about the page itself as a stage and the dancer across it and what to do with that dancer. When I was a really young kid, sometimes as an artist, I would try to keep all my colors separate. I would try to, you know, keep my yellows really yellow and my reds really red. But then you realize that in the world, nothing is separate like that. You know, every red has some yellow in it. Every, you know, green has some blue in it. And so if you really want to make something that jumps off a page, you got to like mash it up. You can really work into the paper. You can work into the mashing up of a thing so that you can make the world that reflects all of the kind of diversity of things that are around you. The richer it is, the more layered it is, the better the work will be. This scene where Misty embraces this role as the Firebird, it's a pivotal scene. It's a scene in which she kind of has arrived as a ballet dancer. And to hold all of the weight of that, all of the kind of importance of that, I had to do a lot of research. I had to do a lot of thinking about both, you know, what this classical role is, and also the ways in which Misty specifically embodied that role. And then I got to also see, through many, many times watching Misty dance, to see how she specifically danced the Firebird, how the Firebird became her, and how she brought herself to the role in a way that I was just stunned by. She made it her own in a way that I think is still resonating today.
Chris and Misty, thank you for sharing this story of achieving our dreams with determination. Your words and art have inspired us to fly with confidence.
Thank you, Aoki, and all the kids who are watching. Bye.
Thanks so much, Aoki, and thank you to the kids. Go and make some more stuff. I want to see. Bye.
Parents and educators, be sure to check out more creative ideas at Crayola.com/creativityweek. And remember to share kids' artwork. Post a photo on social media using #CrayolaCreativityWeek for a chance to win today's amazing giveaway.